University Challenge. Asking the questions, Jeremy Paxman.
Hello. The winners and losers in this quarterfinal stage of the competition are starting to emerge, with Bristol having taken the minibus home, while Emmanuel College Cambridge have seized the first of the four places in the semi-finals. Whichever team wins tonight will join them there, as both of them have already won a quarter-final victory. The losers will return for one final chance to qualify. Now, the team from the University of Edinburgh arrived here by means of a win over Durham University in round one, a win on a tie-break against the Open University in round two, and a comfortable defeat of the University of Birmingham in their first quarter-final. With a total of 605 points earned on those previous appearances, let's meet the Edinburgh team for the fourth time.
Hello, my name's Luke. I'm from York originally, and I'm taking late antique Islamic and Byzantine studies.
Hi, I'm Ewan. I'm from Aberdeen, and I study classics.
And this is their captain.
Hi, I'm Joe. I'm from Brighton, and I study ecology and environmental science.
Hello, I'm Emily, originally from Wilmslow, Cheshire, and I'm studying chemistry.
Playing them, the team from Wolfson College, Cambridge, also have an unblemished record and arrived here by beating the School of Oriental and African Studies in round one, Jesus College, Cambridge in round two, and Balliol College, Oxford in their first quarterfinal match. Those three victories have given them an accumulated score of 575 points. Let's meet the Wolfson team again.
Hi, my name is Justin Yang. I'm from Vancouver, Canada, and I'm studying for a PhD in public health and primary care.
Hi, I'm Ben Chowdhury. I'm from near Cockermouth in Cumbria, and I'm studying natural sciences.
And this is their captain.
Hi, my name is Eric Monkman. I'm from Oakville, Canada, and I'm studying economics.
Hi, I'm Paul Cosgrove. I'm from Cookstown in Northern Ireland, and I'm studying nuclear engineering.
Well, you all probably know the rules better than I do, so fingers on the buzzers. Here's your first starter for 10. For what do the initials HDI stand in the context of a composite statistic relating to a country and based...
Wolfson Monkman.
Human Development Indicator?
No,
Edinburgh Smith.
Human Development Index?
Correct. I'm afraid you've lost 5 points there, Wolfson, for that incorrect interruption. Right, so you get the first set of bonuses, Edinburgh. They're on thinkers of the Scottish Enlightenment. Which Edinburgh-born philosopher was the author of the three-volume Treatise of Human Nature, despite its later significance? On its publication in 1738, Well, it was David Hume, yes. I could have finished the question for you. Secondly, for 5 points, which Scottish philosopher agreed with Hume that ideas about the world are based on reasoning that cannot be proved? In 1764, he published an inquiry into the human mind on the principles of common sense.
James Mill?
No, it was Thomas Reed. In the 1759 work, The Theory of Moral Sentiments, which friend and ally of Hume suggested Adam that Smith. People are guided in morality by an internal sympathy for the emotions of others?
Adam Smith.
Correct. 10 points for this. In the 12th century work, The History of the Kings of Britain, what did Geoffrey of Monmouth refer to as Career Gigantum, or the Giant's Dance? He stated that it had been brought to Britain from Ireland by the magic of Merlin as a monument...
Wolfson Monkman.
Stonehenge?
Correct. These bonuses, Wolfson, are on French territories. Renamed Île-de-France by the French East India Company in 1721, which island was captured by Britain in 1810 and reverted to its former name after a Dutch statesman? It became independent in 1968.
No, Dutch statesman's name would be like Martinique, maybe? Martinique?
No, it's Mauritius. Overthrown by the Portuguese in 1567, La France Antarctique was a short-lived colony in which present-day country?
Chile?
No, it was Brazil. Slightly larger than Wales, which country became independent in 1977, having been successively known as French Somaliland and the French territory of the Afars and Issas?
Djibouti, maybe? Djibouti?
Djibouti's correct, yes. Right, 10 points for this. What precise concept in literature did W.H. Auden describe as the noblest form of stoicism? P.G. Wodehouse thought it was the kindly contemplation of the incongruous, while Angela Carter defined it as tragedy that happens to other people.
Orson Chowdhury.
Comedy.
Comedy is correct. These bonuses, Wolfson, are on astronomy. Using the sun as a base unit of mass, Jupiter weighs in at almost exactly one millisun. In the same way, using the standard SI prefixes attached to the word sun, give me the units missing in the following. Earth's mass is approximately 3 what?
Nano.
Microsuns?
I would say nano.
Nanosuns?
Okay.
Nanosuns?
Okay.
Nano?
No, they're microsuns. Secondly, the dark object at the centre of our galaxy, thought to be a black hole, has been estimated to have a mass of roughly 4 what?
Gigasuns? Giga.
Gigasun.
Gigasuns?
No, they're megasuns. And finally, the mass of Earth's moon is approximately 35 what?
Nano.
Nanos.
Nano.
We had micro.
I think nanos.
Nano? Nanosuns is correct, yes. Another starter question now. Introduced by the British statistician Ronald Fisher in 1925, what commonly used index of the strength of evidence measures the probability of whether an observed result can be attributed to chance? The smaller its value...
Edinburgh Boyle.
P-value.
P-value is right. So you retake the lead, you get a set of bonuses on the architectural style known as brick Gothic or Hanseatic. Firstly, begun in the 1170s and an early example of the brick Gothic style, Roskilde Cathedral houses the remains of 39 kings and queens of which country?
Roskilde. Is it Denmark?
Oh, yeah.
Roskilde is an island.
Is that Denmark?
Denmark?
Correct.
Well done.
The centre of which city in West Flanders is a World Heritage Site noted, among other things, for its brick Gothic architecture? Jan van Eyck spent his final years there.
Bruges. Bruges.
Correct. And finally, the brick Gothic Holsten Tor is a noted structure in which city in Schleswig-Holstein, southeast of Kiel? It was the birthplace of Thomas Mann.
Lübeck.
Lübeck.
Lübeck is right. We're going to take a picture round. For your picture starter, you'll see a map of some of the states of India highlighted to reflect the proportion of those states' populations that speak a specific primary language. The darker the highlighting, the higher the proportion of speakers of that language within that state. For 10 points, I want you to identify the language.
Wolfson Monkman.
Urdu.
No.
Edinburgh Goddard.
Gujarati.
No, it's Punjabi. OK, so we'll take the picture bonuses in a moment or two, but here's another starter question. 10 points for this. Which element of the platinum group is alloyed with platinum to form the international prototype kilogram?
Orson Cosgrove.
Iridium.
Iridium is right. Your picture bonuses are 3 more maps of some of the states of India, again highlighted to reflect the proportion of each state's population that speaks a specific scheduled language of India as a first language. In each case, all you have to do is to work out which language each map refers to. Firstly...
I would say Tamil.
Tamil.
Tamil. Tamil.
No, it's Telugu. Oh. Secondly...
Portuguese, maybe? Or no, that's dark there, no. OK, then, Maratha?
I don't know, you go.
Maratha?
I'll accept that's Marathi, yes, or Marathi, yes. Finally...
That would be Bengali.
Yeah.
Bengali.
Bengali is correct. 10 points for this. A hard, howling, tossing water scene. Strong tide was washing hero clean. These two lines both appear in David Shulman's 1936 anagrammatic sonnet, in which each line is an anagram of what four-word title, denoting a moment in US history depicted in a painting by Emanuel Lenzer.
Edinburgh Smith.
Washington crossing the Delaware?
Correct. You get a set of bonuses on matrices. Firstly, for 5 points, what term is used for a square real-valued matrix M such that M is equal to the transpose of M?
Is it an inverse?
Inverse?
No, it's a symmetric matrix. Secondly, what two-word name describes the matrix M if, given any non-zero vector Z, the expression Z transpose times M times Z is strictly greater than zero?
Interesting, interesting.
Mm. Positive?
I know, it's positive definite matrix. 5 points for this. What name is given to the form of matrix decomposition in which a symmetric real-valued positive definite matrix M is written in the form L times L transpose, where L is a lower triangular matrix?
Dot product.
A dot product matrix?
No, it's a Kolesky decomposition. 10 points for this. Which youth organisation was founded by William Alexander Smith in Glasgow in 1883, having an emblem consisting of an anchor bearing the motto Sure and Steadfast, circumscribed by the letters BB?
Edinburgh Goddard.
Boys Brigade.
Correct. These bonuses are on a church in Florence, Edinburgh. Firstly, noted for its many works of Gothic and early Renaissance art, which Franciscan church in Florence is the burial place of Michelangelo, Galileo and Rossini?
Santa Croce.
Santa Croce?
Santa Croce is correct, the Church of the Holy Cross. From an 1817 account of his sensations on seeing Giotto's frescoes at Santa Croce, which French novelist's name is given to a syndrome caused by a marked emotional reaction to viewing a great number of artworks in a short time?
Nominate Smith.
Stendhal.
Stendhal is correct. In Santa Croce with no Baedeker is the title of the second chapter in which novel of 1908?
A Room with a View.
Correct. 10 points for this starter question. When they have each of the vowels placed between them in turn in the order A, E, I, O, U, which two consonants produce three-letter words that can mean took an exam, solidified...
Edinburgh Goddard.
S and T.
Correct. Right, these bonuses are on the Lancashire-born astronomer William Lassell. Firstly, which satellite did Lassell discover in 1846, only weeks after the discovery of the planet that it orbits? Slightly smaller than Earth's moon, it bears the name of a merman in Greek mythology.
Triton's a satellite.
Triton?
Correct. Lassell is often credited with the discovery in 1851 of which two moons of Uranus? They bear the names of characters in Alexander Pope's poem, The Rape of the Lock.
It's Ariel and Belinda, but it could be Ariel and Belinda. So, the rest of me, that name.
Oberon and Miranda of Shakespeare.
Yeah.
So, yeah, go for
it. Ariel and Belinda?
No, it's Ariel and Umbriel. And finally, which satellite of Saturn was discovered by Lassell and independently by William and George Bond? It shares its name with the fragmentary poetic epic by John Keats.
Enceladus, or Keats?
Could be Hyperion.
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 Hyperion?
Correct. 10 points for this. Quote, he shared with Shakespeare the same sense of character, of the freedom which a character can possess in a great work of art. These words of the academic John Bailey refer to which literary figure born in 1799? They appear in a commemorative work subtitled A Celebration of Russia's Best-Loved Writer.
Edinburgh Smith.
Pushkin.
Pushkin is right. These bonuses are on Western Europe, Edinburgh. The UN Statistics Division defines Western Europe as including France, Belgium, the Netherlands, Luxembourg, Switzerland, Germany and Austria, a total area of around 1.1 million square kilometres. Which crescent-shaped autonomous region of China is the closest in size to that?
Maybe the top that's yeah. Is that Inner Mongolia?
Oh, yeah. What's that? Outer Mongolia, which is...
Inner Mongolia?
Correct. Yeah. Adding Italy, Spain and Portugal to the above figure gives a total area of just over 2 million square kilometres. Which Canadian territory has an area closest to that?
I'm going to say Nunavut, I think, is the biggest one. It's the northern ones are the biggest, so Nunavut, northwestern territory.
Sorry.
Yeah, but...
No.
I have no idea, man.
None of it?
Correct. Finally, adding the UK and Ireland gives a total of 2.32 million square kilometres, an area slightly smaller than that of which Australian state?
Western Australia. It's the biggest one.
Yeah. Western Australia?
That is correct. Right, we're going to take a music round now. For your music starter, you're going to hear a piece of classical music. For 10 points, I want you to identify the composer.
Edinburgh Smith.
Shostakovich.
No, you can hear a little more, Wolfson.
Orson Monkman.
Saint-Saëns.
Correct, it's part of the Danse Macabre. You're going to hear three more dances of death for your bonuses. In each case, I want you to identify the composer. Firstly, this Russian composer.
Prokofiev?
No, that was the Trepak from Mussorgsky's Songs and Dances of Death. Secondly, another Russian composer.
Prokofiev.
No, that's Shostakovich. Mm. And finally, this Austrian composer, please.
It's Beethoven. Beethoven.
No, that was from Schubert's string quartet number 14, known as Death and the Maiden. 10 points for this. Answer as soon as your name is called. Reading the periodic table from the top down, the symbols of the first, fourth, and fifth halogen elements spell which Latin subjunctive form? This is getting embarrassing.
A Fiat.
Orson Childrick.
Fiat is correct, yes, well done. You get a set of bonuses. Got there in the end, well done. Yeah. You'll get a set of bonuses on Susan Sontag, Wolfson. In an eponymous work of 1977, what creative pursuit did Sontag say has become almost as widely practiced an amusement as sex and dancing?
Watching television.
I thought photography.
Television. I like television. Watching TV?
No, it's photography. Oh, I even think watching television is a creative pursuit. I don't know. Right, 5 points for this. A 1999 article by Susan Sontag bore the title, Why Are We In Which Balkan Region? NATO intervention resolved a conflict there, and by 2008, the US and many EU member states had recognized its independence.
Oh, Kosovo, yeah.
Kosovo. Correct. In a 1982 speech, what precise ideology did Sontag describe as the most successful variant of fascism? Fascism with a human face.
Patriotism?
Or nationalism?
Nationalism?
No, it's communism. Yeah. 10 points for this. The winner of the 1964 Nobel Prize in Chemistry, which British X-ray crystallographer was instrumental in...
Orson Monkman.
Hodgkin?
It was Dorothy Hodgkin, yes. These bonuses are on the human skeleton, Wilson. The name of which bone in the arm is the Latin for the spoke of a wheel or a pointed rod?
Radius. Fibula. Radius.
Radius? Yeah. Radius?
Correct. The name of which bone in the leg is the Latin for a pipe or flute?
Fibula.
Fibula?
No, it's tibia. And finally, supposedly resembling the pin of a fastening, which bone in the leg takes its name from the Latin for a brooch?
That's fibula.
Fibula.
That is the fibula, yes. 10 points for this. From a Tupi Guarani word, what is the common name of Panthera onca, the largest New World member of the cat family?
Edinburgh Boyle.
Jaguar.
Jaguar is right. Your bonuses this time, Edinburgh, are on film titles that include the name of a food grain. In each case, name the work from the description. Firstly, a 1914 melodrama adapted from an autobiographical novel by Jack London. Its title refers to a traditional representation of alcohol.
Representation of...
Must be grain.
Wheat. Something about wheat.
Rye.
Yeah, we don't know.
It's John Barleycorn. Secondly, a 1987 film by the Chinese director Zhang Yimou. The grain in question is widely used in China for distilling.
Is it rye?
I was thinking rice, but...
get rice wines.
I can't think of anything with rice.
We don't know.
It's Red Sorghum. And finally, a 2006 film by Ken Loach, set in Ireland in the early...
The Wind That Shakes the Barley?
The Wind That Shakes the Barley is correct. Right, 10 points for this. Joliber, Mayo Balio and Quarra are among names given to which African river? It rises in the Fouta Djallon Highlands and runs for more than 4,000 kilometres before discharging into the Gulf of Guinea.
Orson Chowdhury.
The Congo.
No. Anyone want to buzz from Edinburgh? You may not confer. One of you can buzz.
Edinburgh Smith.
The River Niger.
It is the Niger, yes. These bonuses are on South America, Edinburgh, often cited as the highest navigable lake in the world. Lake Titicaca straddles the border between which two countries?
Peru and Bolivia.
Correct. Secondly, a large... Why is it so funny? Secondly, a large low-lying grassland plain in the drainage basin of the Orinoco River, the region known as Los Llanos, is shared between which two countries?
What's the northernmost one there? I think it's
Guyana.
Is it
Suriname?
I think it's Suriname.
Well, Guyana is northern, and so it's more north.
Are you sure?
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know. Okay. I didn't know it was
Guyana
and Venezuela.
Guyana and Venezuela?
No, it's Colombia and Venezuela. And finally, Aconcagua, the highest mountain in South America, lies close to the border between which two countries?
Chile and Argentina.
Correct. We're going to take a second picture round now. For your picture starter, you'll see a picture of a scientist. 10 points if you can identify him.
Orson Monkman.
Mendeleev?
It is Mendeleev, yes. He was the father of the periodic table. He also gives his name to element 101, Mendeleevium. Your picture bonuses are photographs of three more scientists who have chemical elements named after them. For the 5 points in each case, I just need the name of the scientist. Firstly, for five...
That's Bohr.
Bohr.
It is Niels Bohr. Secondly,
Meitner.
It is Lisa Meitner. And finally,
that's Rutherford. Rutherford.
It is Ernest Rutherford. Yes. 10 points at stake for this starter question. Hallucinations and Awakenings are works by which British neurologist who died in 2015?
Orson Chowdhury.
Oliver Sacks.
Oliver Sacks is right, yes. Wilson, these bonuses are on chemistry. In chemistry, the space-filling CPK molecular models are named after Walter Colton and which two other scientists? I only need their surnames.
PK.
Don't know.
Just pass, then.
Khan, Perlog Khan. I don't know.
Nominate Chowdhury.
Made up. Perlog Khan.
No, it's Corey and Pauling. In the CPK colour code, carbon is black and oxygen is red. What colour is phosphorus?
Yellow?
White.
No, it's purple. Finally, which element is sky blue in the CPK code?
Nitrogen.
Nitrogen is right. 4.5 minutes ago, 10 points for this. The Grito de Dolores, or Cry of Dolores, is often considered to be the starting point of...
Orson Monkman.
The Mexican Revolution.
I'll accept that, yes. Good. Here are your bonuses. They're on books about language, Wolfson. In the 2014 book The Language Myth, Vivian Evans, professor of linguistics at Bangor University, attempts to refute both the notion of a language instinct and which U.S. linguist's idea of an inborn...
Noam Chomsky.
Correct. Yeah. Which Canadian-American psychologist is the author of the 1994 book The Language Instinct, How the Mind Creates Language?
Pinker.
Correct. Which Paris-born U.S. literary critic took issue with the formulaics of Chomsky's language theory in After Babel, Aspects of Language and Translation?
Strauss.
That was George Steiner. 10 points for this. Listen carefully. Answer as soon as your name is called. Give both the month and the year in which King Edward VIII abdicated the British throne.
Orson Monkman.
July 1936.
Anyone like to buzz from Edinburgh?
Edinburgh Smith.
February 1936.
No, it's December 1936. 10 points for this. In the life cycle of all endopterygote insects, that is, those showing hollow metabolism, what is the specific term for the stage that hatches from an egg?
Orson Chowdhury.
Larvae.
Larvae is correct. These bonuses are on words ending in the letters Z-A. In each case, I want you to give the word from the description. Firstly, a thin, plain weave sheer fabric traditionally made from silk.
Is that at taffeta? No, but that's not Z-A.
Pass. It's organza. Secondly, a head cold causing discharge from the nose or eyes.
Influenza.
No, it's coryza. And finally, an annual music festival created by Perry Farrell of the US rock band Jane's Addiction.
Lollapalooza?
Correct. 2 minutes to go, 10 points for this. What was the original language of the novels published in English as The Betrothed, The Tartar...
Edinburgh Smith.
Italian.
Correct. These bonuses are on English counties. All three answers end in shire. The first three letters of the name of which county spell a machine part used, for example, to transform rotary motion into linear motion?
Cambridgeshire.
Correct. The first three letters of the name of which county spell a Polynesian garland of flowers, shells or feathers?
Leicestershire.
Leicestershire.
Correct. And finally, the first three letters of the name of which county spell the nickname of an Argentinian-born revolutionary...
Cheshire.
Cheshire is correct. 10 points for this. Brian Ferniehuff's Unity capsule, Arthur Honegger's Danse de la Chèvre and Claude Debussy's Syrinx are all solo compositions for which woodwind instrument?
Wolfson Monkman.
Clarinet.
Edinburgh Smith.
Flute.
It's the flute. These bonuses are on medical conditions of the spine, Edinburgh. From the Greek meaning bent, which medical condition is characterised by an abnormal lateral curvature of the spine? We'd better have this, please.
We don't know.
It's scoliosis. From the Greek meaning bent backwards, what name is given to the condition characterised by an inward curvature of the spine?
Something saddleback on horses.
Come on, let's have it.
Endoscoliosis?
No, it's lordosis. And finally, from the Greek for hump and commonly known as hunchback, what is the medical term for an excessive outward curvature of the spine? You don't know?
We don't know.
It's kyphosis. 10 points for this. The suffix which, that's W-I-C-H, in the names of towns...
Wilson Monkman.
Sand... salt production. Salt.
They produce salt. I had to take the first thing that you buzz in to stay, and you said sand.
Yes, sorry.
And there's no point in my giving it to the other side, because you've told them what the answer is. It is salt, of course. And at the gong, Wilson College, Cambridge have 160, but Edinburgh University have 195. Well, Wolfson, you came back very strongly. We will certainly be seeing you again in another quarter-final. Possibly, who knows, beyond that. Edinburgh, congratulations. That was a terrific performance from you, and we should look forward to seeing you in the semi-finals. I hope you can join us next time for another quarter-final match, but until then, it's goodbye from Wolfson College, Cambridge.
Goodbye.
It's goodbye from Edinburgh University.
Goodbye.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye.